first good purchase. Amazing. And what a perfect night. I mean, can we have ordered a more perfect night? I think not. The only thing that will make tonight better is if you all sing along. Can you do it? Alright, it's very easy. The words are counted. Thank you. entangled. Okay, stop. All right, hey everybody. Speaking of amazing men, this guy on my right, David Freiberg.
Thank you.
So I know you guys were on your way here tonight, and you were in the car, you were walking here, and you were saying to each other, I wonder what songs they're going to play. I hope they don't play anything new. Well, as luck would have it, we released a new record in 2020, the best year of all to release anything that you want to hear. And it's called Mother of the Sun, and they finally let us out of the house, and we'd like to play a couple of the songs for you, if you don't mind. This song, this particular song, is a very timely song, I would say. And we wrote this with Grace Slick, the queen of rock and roll, original singer of Jefferson Starship. No, I'm not Grace Slick, in case you're still tripping on acid from the 60s. However, she did write this song with us, and it's a women's empowerment anthem that we all need right now, and sing along if you agree.
Thank you.
So David's gonna sing this next one. And I was told where our merch.
Thanks, Todd.
There's a merchandise tent with t-shirts and albums and things. It's to my right in the trees. I see a tent that says beer, but that can't be it.
No, it's right over here.
Where's it? I can't, it's in my blind spot, but you guys know where it is?
It's right here. It's right here.
Okay. Follow each other to go there. Not right now, but soon. And we've got some autographed copies of the record if you'd like to check it out. It's called Mother of the Sun. David's going to sing this one. It's called Setting Sun.
Thank you.
Donnie Baldwin remembers the 80s. He was there. Donnie, there he is. Oh, there he is right there. Donnie Baldwin, everybody. Donnie played and sang on all the great hits of Starship. That's right. Everybody knows that Donnie is a badass drummer. But not everybody knows that he's also an incredible singer and he sings all the high harmonies in the band. Isn't that right, Donnie?
That's so true, Daniel. Thank you.
See what I mean? All right, so.
Thank you.
always hits with something new. This is Jude Ball on the lead guitar, everybody. On the Surrealistic Pillow, Jefferson Airplane album, Jorma Kalkinen did this song as an acoustic fingerstyle instrumental. And Jude has taken it as we do into the future. So give it up for Jude's embryonic journey.
Thank you.
Stage And he's probably here tonight, and you know, maybe he'll make the lights blink on and off or something. So thank you, Paul Kantner, and thank you, Grace Slick, who's still with us, but just doesn't sing anymore, and she's given us her blessing to keep going, and it's an honor and privilege to stand in the shadow of a legend like Grace Slick. So thank you. And very not least, he's not last, he's first, ladies and gentlemen, first. He came from the 60s. Yeah. Yeah, they read Jack Kerouac and they hitchhiked to San Francisco and they put on a beret and they smoked cigarettes and they sang folk music around a microphone with a banjo and an acoustic guitar, and they sang pink songs with people like Jerry Garcia and Paul Kantner and Jorma Kalkinen and Janis Joplin. Yeah, well, that's a whole other story. David is one of the only people that I've ever heard of that got deported from Mexico back to the United States. That's a whole other story, but when he arrived, they sent him to Texas on a plane. And they got off and they went to the University of Texas and they went to the Folk Music Alliance at UT, and they saw this girl singing Irish murder ballads playing an auto harp. And they said, wow, man, you're really good. You should come out to San Francisco. There's a scene happening out there. And she said, really? Well, I have nowhere to stay. And he said, well, you could crash on my floor, man. And so she said, okay. And she hitchhiked out to San Francisco. You know who it was? It was Janis Joplin. That's right. So in a weird way, he discovered Janis Joplin. We won't take credit for that, but just service. Yeah. He later joined Jefferson Airplane, replacing Marty Gallo, as he was the best male singer around in San Francisco at the time. And then Jefferson Airplane broke up, and he went to Egypt with the Grateful Dead. No one knows why. What they were doing now, but the legacy remains. And they said, hey, David, would you like to join the Grateful Dead? He said, yeah, I'd love to, but I can't, because I'm starting a new band with Grace Slick and Paul Kantner called the Jefferson Starship. Yeah, we're going into the future.
Thank you.
You guys want to hear another song? Okay. This next question is going to be really, really difficult for everyone. So, like, everybody just hang on 1 second. Let me just ask. What song do you guys want to hear? We have a man right here in the front row says 3/5 of a mile.